Her Excellency, and distinguished partners, and dear members of the press. First, I would like to express my sincere thanks to Mr. Baybars Altuntas for inviting me to speak for this wonderful conference and has a chance to be with you. So I'm the president of KAGİDER, Women Entrepreneurs Organizations of Turkey, and we are one of the leading organizations of women entrepreneurs. As you see, I'm also a woman entrepreneur. We have more than 300 members. They're all women entrepreneurs, and they have the turnover around 2 billion euro annually. And we are an NGO, non-profit organizations, and working for the women empowerment. And our mission is to develop and support women entrepreneurship to strengthen women's status, both economically, socially, and politically. And we have a dream. We work for a world in which women produce and express their existence freely and play an effective role in decision making. And as Baybars told, that I really congratulate to be the part of the G20, and you also know KAGİDER is the president of Women 20 during the Turkish presidency, G20. And there is a goal there that to reduce the employment gap between men and women 25% until 2025. So it's our mission also, it's our goal also, working for the employment and for empowerment of women. And today I also want to mention a word, most probably you know, the word, the Japanese word, ikegai. I'm sure you have heard it before. And a reason of being, the reason for you to get out of every morning. It's a kind of a joy that wake you up. So the idea is also very popular, not only in Japan, but out of the world. And ikigai is thought to combine the Japanese words ikiguru, meaning to live, and kai, meaning the realization of what one hopes for. Together, these definitions create the concept of a reason to live, an idea of having a purpose of life. So, to find this reason or purpose, experts also recommended to ask yourself, what does the world need from you? And I think today, we are going to underline why the world needs money, investment, and why we are doing why we need the social impact. So, as KAGİDER, we are voluntarily work for our ikigai, for women empowerment, and help for creating impactful investment. Why do we have this dream? Why do we want to empower women? In the worldwide, the women business owners in the worldwide is 392 million. For every 100 male, there are only 69 female business owners. And according to gender gap that McKinsey says, if we could have reached gender equality by now, there would have been $28 trillion increase in the global GDP, which means that a country such as China or United States can be added in the world economy. So while we are looking to Turkey's numbers, only 33% of participation to labor force, and 8 of the business are owned by women only. So there is a big untapped potential of women in for economic growth and economic development. Yes, this is an economic issue, but nevertheless, not only an economic issue, because women's economic empowerment is key to the realization of women's rights, to achieving a truly gender equal world. Economically empowered women also have access to a decent work, control over economic resources and over their own time, participating meaningfully in economic decision makings. Economies grow faster, but families are healthier and better educated. So that's why we need to realize this untapped potential if we need it for a better world. So to create impact, investors should also be focusing on women's empowerment. As you know, the world has been talking about women empowerment for many years. And according to today, in order to reach the gender gap equality, we need to wait more than 181 years. So it is a really a long way. So we don't need to wait for that long and start to do something meaningful, something impactful for the companies, for business owners, for the investments that can be changed for world. As you know, today most of the companies have also purpose. They work for the purpose as a mission. And civil society is running more sustainable projects. And the projects aim to have a better world, to create impact on the society. And the project also aim to generate income to run the system and to increase the scope. The world is talking about social entrepreneurship more and more. And social entrepreneurship is attracting growing amounts of talent, money, and attention. So today, the world needs and wants companies with a purpose, not philanthropy. I want to share some numbers that recently an FMCG company did research on the consumer preferences. The study asked almost 20,000 adults in 5 countries how the sustainability concern impact their choices. And they said that 33 of them says that they buy brands based on their social and environmental impact. An estimated 96 million euro opportunity exists for brands that make their sustainable credential clear. And another report says that, do you know what the millennials want? They are the next customers. They are the next one coming through. And they said that they want companies to be actively invested in the betterment of society at the solution of social problems. They want companies that prioritize making an impact on the world around them. They want companies to be open and honest by their efforts and to be public about their pro-social initiatives. Finally, millennials want companies to involve their customers in their good works. They want an opportunity to give back, whether it is with a gift or their time or their money. So consumer wants a better, purposeful brands. But what about the companies if they act on a purpose base? Again, another research said that between 2013 and 16, purpose-driven companies enjoyed 85% growth in their revenues. On the other hand, 43% of companies with no purpose or that can't articulate to the good mission showed a drop in their revenues. And employees also want to work in a good world, in a good brand that give a purpose. Competitive salaries and benefits are great, but when you ask an employee, why do you work a company? 65% of people across various countries want to work for an organization with a strong social consciousness. Companies that promote active corporate volunteer programs see higher employee morale and a healthier, more energetic culture, and that translate to a more profitable bottom line. So, for employee, for a brand choice, and for a consumer side, social impact is important. And Kagider as an association work for an impact also. And I want to share 2 examples of our members who have a social business which impact the women empowerment. One is Bedriye Hülya, who is the founder of BeFit, Sports and Life Center for Women. The purpose of the BeFit is for women to encourage them to gain their independence by sports, by making exercise. And you know, as a mother, it's not easy to make a regular exercises for you if you have a child. So she built a sports centers that you can go, owned by women, that you can feel yourself more relaxed, and you can make your training programs. It could be like 20 minutes, it could be half an hour, 1 hour, or 2 hours. So this model, only for open for women, there is a little playground for the children. So if you want to open this kind of a sports salon, which it could be a small street, corner street shops, so there is only, you can make exercises 10 or 15 women at the same time. So it's a BeFit also shows them how to build their companies, how to be an entrepreneur, and how to manage their companies. So it's a very sustainable model which makes the social impact. Because in Turkey, even going out and having a free time for a woman, it's a real gift. Because it's also socialization, not only socialization, but also meeting with other people and making exercises. The second example is Tülin Akın. She's the co-founder of Tabit. Her company is building an information platform to act as an enabling architecture for Turkey's 3 million farmer families to fully and actively participate in the economy and society by combining informative technologies and agriculture together. So the agriculture sector and farmers themselves do not benefit from these remarkable tools. She's bringing together two unlikely friends together. Now she opens a village in the Aegean coast, and she called this place as a smart village. She can not only introduce and educate the farmers, especially for the women, but also she helps the village to transfer itself by using technology to sell their products, to access to the market, and to access their capacities by using the technology. So I would briefly to share also some of the examples, Kagider impactful social business models. And I also remind that the two business had investments internationally and nationally, and they still growing their business. And I also mentioned Kagider two impactful projects. One is childcare model, the first one. For women empowerment, childcare system is also very important. And you need to create a model that woman and mother can work. So what we offer is to be an entrepreneur for a woman, open a childcare house by getting mothers who has been selected and supported by the government. So it's a 300 TL, and it will be a good initiative to introduce more women to join the labor force. I also want to give, Pradlu said that last week the initiative proposal went on the National Assembly to discuss and voted for. I'm really very hopeful if it passed. It means that the most women entrepreneurs can be in the market, and also most of the mothers, not only mothers, but also fathers, parents, can use these childcare systems. And by their giving their taxes, according to our model, By giving only 300, the government earns 500 TL as a tax in the long term. So this sustainable model and social impactful model also impact the society. So, in the closing of my speech, I would like to underline again that the future is of our social business models. Business models that generate income while following a dream of making the world a better place. The future of investment is impact investment. Both the investors and the consumers will be looking for ikigai, the purpose, the reason. Follow your dream. Find your ikigai, because our ikigai is empowering women. Thank you for listening to me.